Lina mid. Jeez. It's too fast for me. God damn it. Clicking is hard. Sorry guys, just trying to get the camera setting sorted out here. Alright, should be good. Slaughter Undying is not a particularly strong lane, but you are gonna be up against an Ember. Oh no, actually I guess it's the gyro lane, so I'm not a big fan of this offlane for Secret. I think they're gonna struggle, but they get some good wards down and they're not scouted. That will definitely help the offlane quite a bit.
Yeah, meanwhile the LGD lanes are also fairly standard. You're gonna have a Darkseer, maybe the Bane's gonna rotate and help out a bit, but for the most part we're gonna see probably a defensive try lane with a bit of roaming and stacking towards mid. I don't think you could make an argument for any lane having a really strong, any team having a really strong advantage.
Hey, can you try to move your mic like a little closer to the corner of your mouth? Would that zap yourself? Is that possible?
That would literally zap me.
Okay.
But I'll take a bit.
No, you don't have to zap yourself. It's okay. All right, guys, we're doing what we can. Game one, Secret versus LGD. Here we go. So Secret, all clustering up near the bottom bounty rune, the top bounty rune, LGD.
I'm too loud. According to one person. Which I'm not sure if I'm.
Libby's too loud. Libby's too quiet. LD's too loud. LD's too quiet. God damn it, Chad. I think we're just gonna put them on subscribe for about the rest of the tournament.
Or we could. We're done after this, right?
Just... Mm-hmm.
Just bear with it, guys.
Hang on. It'll be okay.
Hello, Winter. Hello. I think both of our sanity has been pretty much drained at this point.
Get back. Oh, wow. Now I'm too loud. Alright, let's, Let's just keep them even. I think my microphone fell off my ear because of the friggin' hoodie. Alright, sorry about that, guys. We're trying here. MMY gonna be... So, looking at the lanes now. They're gonna have the Tusk Darkseer dual lane. We normally see that Spiritbreaker Darkseer, but obviously, similar kind of concept to fairly tanky heroes. They can just run at you with double Ion Shell. A little bit easier catch, I would say. Looks like DDC is gonna be able to deorders cap. They're up against a Disruptor as well as a Quake, so good laning harass, but also a bit squishy if they get caught by the shards. There'll be some kill potential here if LGD play it properly. On bottom lane, they're moving in to get the crush off of DDC. He does have a Nightmare. May need to use it just to walk away. Misery gonna back off. Sylar, not yet engaging. Just hanging back. Only the level 1 Rocket Barrage. Oh.
The mid lane, maybe.
Oof. He does salve up. Raiding and push you to the limit while Sylar gets chased. He tries to juke the stun. Not gonna happen. This one dying with 5 decay stacks just mauls him to death. Misery did have the mango. Could have maybe gone for a secondary crush. Well, he tried to get out of the lane. He's like, I want to leave, but what could happen? There is a roam on mid, though. This could be big for the Ember. Setting up, snowballs there. The shard's going to come through. It's a perfect trap. Even body blocking him in a bit. They will get the kill on Weeha's Lina. Very well played. And how does that compare, like, how, and Secret's been winning a lot lately, I guess, so part of it's maybe that they're just playing well right now, but that is an impressive win rate. Oh, nice. He gets the last hit too with the double damage, and that's a big grab. You know, if in a vacuum, maybe it's a slightly difficult matchup for the Ember, but now that he's got the point and Sleight of Fist, the level 3 Flame Guard, he can dodge the Lightstrike Array, he can also set up for the Tusk Roams, and it's just not a fair matchup, Lumi. And how does Secret adjust? Undying's not really a hero that can turn that lane around. Disruptor could maybe save the Lina with a glimpse, but then you're going to give a ton of space to the Darkseer. So I feel like this is where LGD's lanes are just a lot more flexible. They can gank with DDC, they can gank with the Tusk, the Gyro's fairly difficult to punish. There will be a glimpse trying to prevent maybe from at least getting the 4-minute rune. Hope you will grab an illusion.
A soldier's fortune.
I'm of the school of thought that the Orchid is usually not that good, but there's an Ember in the game, and I think they do lack lockdown versus him. You've got Glimpse, Static Storm, that's not bad. That's one of the better, probably the best support, I think, to lockdown Ember, but that's really about it. Blade Crush could work. Obviously, Lina's very bad at controlling an Ember, so I think because there's an Ember in the game, Orchid is a solid choice, but generally, I'm more a fan of the Deso. I feel like it's just the safer item. You could take Roche with it, it helps you push, whereas Orchid only helps you to get kills and control, and doesn't have the same versatility. Right. Who else is a big Orchid carry? Storm, not very strong right now. Brood, I mean, is just a very unique hero. Quap was banned, otherwise I would say Quap's maybe the one other slightly more versatile Orchid carrier than the Clicks. She can go to pretty much any lane. Crush does come on the bottom lane, and Misery's gonna take a bounty here from the Rocket Barrage, but not quite as much as you would have thought. Then the two-hero snowball comes in, suddenly they're trapped. No Decay Stack, Pylai Dai gonna get butchered. Great rotations from MMY. He wins the mid lane, now he's won bottom. How does this hero get through so often? It's always a shocker to me, to be honest. Dire's middle tower is under attack. Winter has been saying for a while that he thinks that Tusk is just the best overall hero. Not always like the strongest in a particular draft, just the most versatile. He gave me a back rub because he loves his Tusk so much. Yeah, he's made a lot happen, and then the pressure's on Eternal Envy, Lumi. Really the only hero having a great time in the laning stage so far, and it's not even that great, it's just that he hasn't died and he's been farming. So, what's the plan here? Generally as Clicks, you go jungle, you give the lane to a support, that is what they're doing currently to get puppies level 6. Ooh, Ember, looking for the chains on Weeha. That's a pity the creeps though, now maybe he's gonna back off. Weeha does have a stun as well as a Laguna Blade, Sleight of Fist is available, doesn't need it. But I got any range. So, what do you expect from Eternal Envy? Because I feel like he's kind of the pivot point for Secret right now. Damn! TK got beat, and they might lose another. Here's the Tusk. Snowballs forward. Reinforcements have arrived, though. Maybe he's into the fight, and he gets glimpsed back, but only into the lane, not back to the mid. So, with that glimpse, we'll disengage. So he saves the Tusk, force the TP, though. They get the Darkseer kill. Nice little win there for Secret. He might just be going Sol Rain Medallion, actually. I suppose that's true. But Bessie's not a terrible item just to hang on to. I don't know. If you don't get Orchid, it does put a lot of pressure on the Disruptor and Slardar to lock down Ember. And maybe is a world-class Ember. He might be the best in the world. He's definitely like in my top three. So he's not someone you can like, oh yeah, maybe he's just gonna get caught and we can outplay him. Like, it's not gonna be easy. Slardar. So the clicks will hit reasonably hard, but
he just definitely
snowball. They are gonna find the clinks. Hey, buddy, dust is there, shards are there, and he quickly starts to drop ion shell. Even the wall committed. LGD with some crisp rotations. Feels like a different team from yesterday. I gotta say, yesterday they looked very lost, but. Now the sleep on Weeha, MMY, waiting for the cooldowns on his spells, but Ember has arrived, maybe. Gonna finish off Weeha, the Laguna Blade almost entirely blocked, but they get the Static Storm down, perfectly placed by Puppy, two heroes locked in position. Weeha gonna survive, snowballing pass through the Static Field. He's got no mana, he's got stick charges, but doesn't have the cooldowns, they're gonna lose all three. Puppy the savior until Sylar shows up, his cooldown hits on two, but Puppy, the second one, not gonna connect. My god, Puppy, Capitan, my Capitan.
Dire's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's top tower is under attack.
He was under a lot of pressure, though, to be fair. Like, not even just the Tusk ganks, but the threat of those ganks. And he, I believe they only had, I forget where the ward was. Well, no, because he didn't see the Tusk coming the first time.
I don't know.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Let's see. Radiant team didn't fully see the Rosh. Did see heroes kind of squirming down towards that bottom lane and checking out Radiant Vision once more. Map is looking a little empty. Bottom lane's kind of pushing in, top lane pushing out. Tombstone down just to be safe and seems secret. We get an uncontested Rosh. And now, with this, it is feeling like maybe the Clicks. Not gonna go Orchid after all. Just a casual Sage's Mask for now.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Envy's Death Pact and Warn off, or he would have easily gotten that kill. Weeha's the one that gets punished. Static Storm gets dropped, but maybe able to walk away. They're glimpsed back. No, already committed it. Maybe even looking to run forward. Perhaps has the chains available. They can surge him in. Stick Charge is also in line, has the Remnant, but doesn't want to overextend. Beautiful. Shards again catching out Eternal Envy. MMY has been on fire.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
How many leading games has he played? A little quap, I guess.
My just reward.
Not everyone can be Sheiki Lumi. Well, I guess the trade-off is, Linus, the one hero that you play at a crazy level. LR is smoked up now. LGD moving down mid. Puppy. They might want some revenge. Ember jumping in right away. There's the glimpse. Get back. Leave me alone. Call down coming through. It's going to hit on two. And maybe jumps right back to the Remnant. He's going to dive on the Pilot. He'll get the kill there as well. Misery in pursuit, but up and down and all the way. Maybe he's going to escape. MMY, maybe not so lucky though. He'll take one for the team. They do still have vision on maybe, but he's full HP. Very healthy. Again, just maybe's individual Ember Spirit play. No margin for error. Gets the Remnant off as the glimpse happens and just jumps right back into the fray.
Radiant's courier has been killed.
Ee-ee-sama. Big courier snipe, but had already delivered the drums. So they go double phase drums. LGD very very early to mid game combat phase. I guess their feeling here is if they could just stay even through the first 20 to 30 minutes, they have the late game, right? You've got Gyro, Ember, Darkseer, amazing teamfight control from the Tusk as well as the Bane. Like, Secret could win late, but if they do, it's because they outplay LGD, not because they beat them late based on lineup. I don't think anything beats Tusk, dude. That hero's ridiculous.
Yeah,
like, if... Medallion is online now. I imagine Deathso probably the next grab as LGD start to clump up mid. They want to play aggressive here. Yules has been picked up for Weehaw, and maybe he's going to be the one to initiate. Went for the chase, but the Yules was used defensively, meaning Weehaw doesn't have any setup. Then the stun misses. They glimpse maybe back. He just jumps away again. It will end up escaping quite easily, in fact. That was a very awkward engagement. And yeah, you're right. Weehaw is definitely struggling a bit here to find the combos. They're going to push now. The difference in League is they're all super low cooldown though, so you just get another shot in like, what, 5 seconds or something? Oh, that ain't happening. No, sorry. No chance in hell. He gets up the Laguna and from the high ground, Eternal Envy will snipe him. Beautifully comboed, even though he dodged the stun. He'll end up going down, but they get the Lina as the trade. One for one, but I think if you're Secret, you're still very happy with that. Killing off maybe, slowing him down is more important than losing your Lina at this point. He's got stick. Does he have enough mana for anything? Maybe he's back into the fray. He rushes forward. He jumps in onto Weehaw. Gets off the chains. They're looking for a bit more of the stun. A complete airball. LGD playing with their food. They pop the drums. They run forward again. He stops to hit illusions and he runs through the wall. Will it cover his retreat? Weehaw. No, sorry. Double remnant forward. Dodging the stun again. The two hero chains. Maybe out of control in this fight. Elmo. Twilight Knight could be next. Somebody stop this friggin' Ember. He's just running roughshod all over them. Eternal Envy suddenly rejoins the fray. They do manage to take down the gyrocopter, but that's it, as maybe dances on their graves on the way out. My god, this guy is a beast. Dire's middle tower is under attack. Alright, well, we've got Bulldonner in chat. His Donner can't take it. Nice stun. Holy shit, that was his expert analysis. Man, Navy is a beast.
Yep.
This is one of the few players, I think. Like, you just, if Ember's there, you can just grab it first every time.
Dire's bottom tower is
what?
Under attack.
Man.
Jesus. Yeah. Lumi, did they not feed you lunch?
I had.
Okay. Okay. So you're seeming, you're feeling a little savage today. You just freshly loaded up your flamethrower.
I don't know. Whatever I see.
Here, it's the Cloud9 legacy. You went from just always showing them love and kindness to anytime they did the slightest misstep, friggin' idiots. Stupid Cloud9.
There you go, Misty. What a player. Get the crush. First Laguna, we have. He goes on the plane show. I don't know about that here. We want Envy on back on. They're all out. It's going to be all dead. And he can have no nice shield here from Twilight Dive.
Oh, they got him.
Other pressure, Misty. Carrying the team, MLY is going to. Another crush. Next crush. big and how broad are your shoulders?
ROTK, the jukes. Okay, he's gonna back away. Yeah, he's gonna try for it. ROTK very low. Any buybacks available? Nobody choosing to use them. A little surprised. That was a close fight, but in the end, Secret with the full five-man takedown. They run away with it, and I mean, you said it well there in the middle of the fight, Lumi. That tombstone was just ignored the entire engagement. A 3,000 gold swing. They committed an entire static storm. Didn't get a kill off of it until the very end on the gyrocopter. It seemed like at that point the Ember can just run freely throughout the fight, but we see the power of Slardar versus him. Ember is one big weakness to me is he's very frail in terms of armor, doesn't have the best stats growth, gets caught by a crush for the amp damage, he just melts. LGD are not to be deterred by this. They're gonna find a wild Weeha. They had the ward in the jungle, and well, Weeha, we'll try to hang on a bit longer. We'll end up going down in the end.
Your fire lacks discipline.
Jesus. Oh my goodness, Lumi. Please.
Okay, like real talk.
A little mercy.
Dire's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's bottom tower.
Okay, he did get roamed on by the Tusk a lot, though. To be fair.
Get a ward.
I don't think it saw all of the gigs, though. It may have seen the one.
Radiant structures.
Save the flamethrower, you've got four more days. Save your ammunition for what it counts. LGD pressing up in this top lane. Both cores are getting farmed. Now Ogre Club up on Sylar, maybe. 2700 gold, we'll see where he wants to take it. We'll see that straight Battle Fury. Really the best Manta game. It's generally not the first item that you want on a... Ember.
Dire's top tower has fallen.
BKB. I feel like the real threat to him as the game progresses is the amp damage. He gets the remnant in the pit. Oh, maybe wanted to jump back in there. Slips back. Almost had the range for it. Not quite though. Secret on the run, now maybe jumps it, gets up to two here, Slate of Fist for the safety of the pit, and then the left wall into the call down. This could be enough for a kill. No, Misery skates away from the high ground. They get off the silence, so maybe he may end up going down. He tried to swag on EE Sama, and Weeha gets his sweet revenge. Guna to the dome, or actually more to the butt. That is, in fact, a 1500 gold swing, but that doesn't even count the value of the Aegis Sword, or I believe the Roshan is. RTK gets a few arrows pumped into him. A first damage item, probably coming soon here, up to 2000 gold. Yeah, normally is the Desolator.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Radiant structures
are They don't. It's kind of good on the Slardar, because then Misery gets a lot tankier. Oh, Chain's not going to connect. In fact, they may go back in. Misery's thinking about it. Vicious zombies. I think for LGD, they don't really need to force it that much. I still consider their late game superior if they get the combo off. So I would like to see them relax a little bit, maybe go for Smoke Gank, but they don't have to force the issue. They're a decent pickoff lineup, but there's a lot more room here to farm. Sylar's BKB. Be crucial this game. There's actually no lockdown for a BKB at all, aside from a bash, but you're not building your fights around that. But and I think that's fine just to get to the late game, but you don't have to win the game now. LGD is definitely not on a clock here. Has Blink Dagger available for usage. They do have some vision of this Radiant jungle, but GD staying together as a pack. Battle Fury probably coming soon. I just think if you get Lincolns that you delay your ability to access late game by too long. It's already 23 minutes in. I think it's still easily died of Blade Cross. That to me is where you don't get Lincolns. He isn't particularly threatening with the BKB. He's a tank, he's kind of a red herring in the fights, and he can make the slaughter a lot scarier, but his personal damage output with the amp damage is still decent, and I guess that's where Turtle Envy is like, well, yeah, I'm not the hardest hitter, but if the slaughter gets a good crush amp, then I can get kills anyway, but definitely a different build up here. We've seen Fear go for it occasionally, but more often than not, it is that Deso first. Oh, Sylar's the BKB, this is trouble for Secret. They gotta back the hell away. They grip up Weeha, trying to finish him off before anything else happens. Snowball onto Misery. Aegis will be popped. MMY now backing off after they've cracked the Aegis, but the crush, the turn for Misery, leaps right back in. There's the cooldown. It hits on 5! Oh no! Secret getting massacred! Maybe running forward. Weeha's dead, slapping them down with the sleight of fist, and Misery's likely to be next. Remnant over. It's a triple for Maybe. But to me, I really gotta give credit to Sylar there, Lumi. He held that cooldown until the perfect moment.
Radiant's top tower is under attack. Dire's bottom tower has fallen.
I like Zombie House. I approve.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
That was the game-winning BKB. If Sylar doesn't have that, there's no way they pull off that fight. And now maybe Battle Fury up, another 700 gold in the bank. That really worries me for Secret because of the way they've itemized as well. Like you've been pointing out, Envy's not going for the hard carry clicks. He's not really split pushing that much. They're building into two BKBs, in fact. Everything's utility for this team, and well, Lina's just so poor that she's kind of a non-factor up to this point. One more auto attack. Close call. Did not have the gyrocopter in that fight, and that's the difference. Just getting caught out. Another great crush by Misery, and there's just no counterplay without the gyro. At that point, you back wall. Secret don't really care. They just kind of run past it. Their own illusions are really not that scary. There's no Shadow Fiend or huge illusion-based hero. They need the call down in these fights, and unfortunately, it just wasn't there. A Glimmer Kid, BKB is gonna dodge it. Sylar with the timing gets up the cooldown. Misery may pay for this. Snowball forward. They punch him up. They smack him down. They'll get the slaughter. Now they look for a bit more RTK. They'll be completely changed. But no back, no wall. He's dead. Envy looking for more. Almost chunks down Sylar. He's gonna commit for it. One last plink from Weeha. We'll get the kill. And now they hunt for MMY. They get the move speed. They clip him back. They've got the vision. It's four down. More TP, Snowball coming, MMY looking to make the great escape, he drops the shard, now DDC coming in, one by one, LGD keep on running forward, maybe trying to get to work here with the Remnants, but the Yule Scepter is going to delay this initiation that he's got, does get caught by the stun, the Sleight of Fist not quite properly timed, now they've caught him, Static Storm, he's chunked down, it's 4 dead, it's 5 dead, I think they've lost 6 or 7 in this fight, Lumi. Oh, Sentry got him with the urn, get him, eat. Sama no more. So, what was that, like 8 kills on LGD? Oh, is it even gonna count all the kills, honestly? Jesus, I feel like that was more than those 5 kills, but denied. So that was a crazy fight. Yeah, as amazing as that fight looked, it isn't that big of a gold swing. 4K gold, not bad, but I think for me it's more just, I feel like Secret are a little more polished in these fights. Ever since that one big fight bottom, RLTK keeps on getting caught. He's not getting the vacuum off, he's not getting the wall off. They need that to take these fights. And they also have to fight as a team, not just going one by one and get picked off. I like the Solar Crest versus the Secret lineup. You definitely want more physical damage mitigation, and that I wouldn't say DDC's played poorly, but I just feel like I haven't felt the impact of the Bane enough to justify it over a Wyvern. We talked about it as the last pick for LGD, was an option. I don't know, there's been one really good Fiend script. That's to me is about it, and that could have basically just been a Winter's Curse anyway.
Yeah, obviously Bane.
He even had the defensive sleep in the fight here, but it did save his teammate. The gyro still went down in the end.
My just reward.
Uh-oh. Like, TP'd out the Ember. Where's his remnant? It's in the Roche pit. Yeah, that, well, he can come back. little risky. Yeah, sure, why not? They're counting a puppy. Oh, Cappy Town, we trust. Misery can also jump out. And they've got the high ground tombstone. Will RTK get the jump? Roche is dropping pretty quickly. Ember, they're definitely gonna look to fight this, but they glimpse him back. RTK kept out of the fight. Puppy with the huge blaze, jumping into the pit, engaging is in the Y Sylar. Now the cooldown will be let loose, but Eternal Envy's gonna BKB. He's okay for now. Heavy physical damage, they'll gun him down with the gyrocopter. Up on the high ground, Weehouse trying to finish the Roche, but Baby says, no, I'm gonna get in there and smack you down, boy. He wants the Mule Scepter. Commitment, Roche, it's the dire last hit, but it's a snatch, and they get Weehouse. Well, now Pi in danger as well, trapped in the river. Eternal Envy unable to rejoin the fight. RTK scurries by, he gets away. Pi, the slow, painful death by Rocket, will end his life, and Misery just kind of stands by idly and watches while Puffy is trapped, surrounded, and punished. Four down, LGD with the big grab. Misery gets the crush, but was it worth it? He may die to a chains. Guys, get him the full range grab, barely trapping Misery. He gets the kill. He's gonna pay. It's a wipe and another grab for maybe. Although Misery, he did everything he could to salvage that. Puppy almost had like the sickest counterplay ever. But that's the power of Tusk. This is a support that has very minimal farm. He still rolls in, stuns everyone in the pit, like gets right past the Static Storm regardless, and buys time for the Darkseer to get in there.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
And now with signature blink, the style points are coming out. The nice thing is now he's got the Aegis, so he can afford to play more aggressively. Still no defensive items. Generally, I mean, we talked about where Lincoln's isn't a great first item. I don't think it's a terrible option against Disruptor. There are a couple of spam boys to break it, mainly the Slardar ultimate. Manta's, I wouldn't say useless, but likely very ineffective this game, so I don't think he'll go Manta here. You mentioned BKB. If he's gonna get one, I don't think it's his next item, but at some point maybe we'll want at least one defensive item besides the blink. I don't mind Scotty. It's obviously gives you good armor, which is nice against the physical damage. The attack speed slow can be handy. It's not an item that maybe normally goes for, though. He tends to play a pretty glass cannon Ember. It's true. But that's like the only thing that it does. Just for amp, I suppose it's decent.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's bottom tower has fallen.
Does. W God, observing quietly in the background.
Radiant's
we'll get a tower top. Misery the one to claim it. Plate mail up. I mean, they need these courier snipes. They're not really. They didn't play greedy at all in terms of items, in terms of like farming patterns, and every bit that they can get is going to be necessary. Sylar, ultimate orb down, boys. He is building towards Amantha. Uh-oh, Snowball's here. They found the tusk, he's gonna roll in quite deep. Blink away, no, he gets stunned, he can't. Bam! That's some physical damage. So, yeah, Sylar Manta coming soon. Still waiting to see, yeah, maybe, with the Crystallis. So, I think if you don't have Aegis here, you may consider that defensive item more, but you can afford to go pure offense with the way the game's shaping up. I give Weehawk credit, though, Lumi. As much as he has missed a bunch of stuns, hasn't had the cleanest Lina game, he still kept his farm up. Finds himself just barely behind the Gyro and the Ember, and they're going to need a farm Lina because Clix's build is not going to allow him to delete heroes from fights, but with an Axe, potentially, Weehawk could do it. With the help of the Slaughter. The late game play for Secret is having hexes, yeah. Lina, honestly, I think Clix is a pretty underrated hex carrier, especially if you opt to skip Orchid. Not now, but as like maybe your fourth or fifth item. And because he's invis as well, it's often a good way to ambush, maybe, so good to pick up his. They're gonna siege, though. They want to take advantage of this Aegis, LGD. Not much time left, though. They'll just be able to get this tier 2, and then they're gonna have to back.
Dire's middle tower has fallen.
Yeah. Just, I mean, Solar Crest is just such a good item. Like, you have to try and counter that. Really? Oh, so like they can't have evasion? Like the counter Solar Crest? That should be a double damage item. Give your teammate a double damage item.
That's like something I was saying after a
I mean, if we're gonna theorycraft, you know, I'm allowed to have a little fun too. Eggs coming fairly soon. Yeah, he stopped off for the Bloodstone, much more of your late game, like hard carry Lina build, which is interesting considering how poorly the game began, but yeah, you definitely need the eggs. It's more the Bloodstone stop off that is less common nowadays, but I think still an okay choice. I favor LGD's teamfight if they execute to the best of their abilities, but it's not to say that Secret can't win late. One, Misery's had great crushes this game, Puppy's been on point. Those two can completely disrupt whatever LGD are looking to do. Did you see that that Eternal Envy died for your sins game? Like it was like a year and a half ago, I think Lysander was casting for you. He was on Tinker, he Bloodstone suicided, and it just allowed his team to take a late of Rex. That was a really fun game. Yeah. Probably MKB the next damage item. He may stop off now for either a BKB or for Lincoln Sphere, possibly Manta. I would agree with that. Smoke, can they wrap around? This could be an excellent angle of assault for LGD. not scouted by the Dire. They didn't see the smoke. They have no wards even remotely in the area, but the rest of the team backs off while Eternal Envy goes in Viz. Prowling about. You can sell the Aquila. Yeah. It's time. Time to run the hell away. And now they're revealed. So he'll just cut it. He'll just cut off and head towards mid. At this point, you need to make sure that you always have death packed up. Oh, they're gonna find Envy though. Dust is there, Snowball comes through. Now the Walrus Punch, lock him in position. He's got a BKB, tries for the TP out. Do they have the lockdown? The grip is there, and EE Sama. Sama no longer will go down. That's a. He has no buyback, Lumi. He's dead for a minute. Hey, I feel they do need Envy pretty badly here. They did commit the grip. And the wall, though. I'm not sure if LGD want to push. Radiant's bottom tower. I don't have that great sieging hero, though. Like, you put the gyro in front, he's not. He just doesn't do that much damage. But he just doesn't hit very hard. It's the main issue. Like, it's gonna take a while to bring this down. But maybe he says, forget about towers, I want kills. Jumps on the puppy, forces out the ghost scepter nice and early. Mantle illusions will come in, and well, I mean, they'll tickle the tower, but. A buyback they don't have. It's one way to avoid forcing. Yeah, of course not. Yeah, it's a good play by LGD. And again, I think they do recognize while they want to push the advantage while their hero's dead, they don't have to win now. They have plenty of room to grow. You get like 2-3 more items easily on maybe. Gyro farming still pretty well. Hasn't gotten that first big damage item yet. Manta much more of a utility item here. And of course, your Darkseer can get the Shiva, the Refresher, a Hex at some point. Like everybody has room to grow on LGD and they're really not in any hurry. Hmm? Something like that, yeah. Come back and beat the stronger late game team. Ah, but... You think they're better at that point?
No, I don't think...
Oh, yeah. I would agree. I think they're only better if they have just, if they outplay. Like, they can only win fights by outplay. Whereas LGD, to me, like, a reasonably decent fight, an average fight, against an average secret fight, they probably win that. They are hunting, though. It's a double smoke from secret. Doesn't find anything. A lot of precious late game resources wasted. Maybe Blake said he goes for the quick change, then jumps out, but he's very far away from his team. Maybe he's actually not going to be here for this initial fight. Silo, though, has the BKB, and maybe he's getting back into position. RTK going to scramble away. Could have been bad, but it didn't have the follow-up to that crush.
Trickster's Rune of Illusion.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
They definitely need a Hex as this game moves along. This Ember is, like, maybe is playing like they basically can't touch him. And not getting punished. Yeah. Interesting grab on Puppy. Don't think we talked about it yet. Gets the Lotus Orb. It gets rid of the Fiend's Grip, right? And also, yeah, just helps keep your allies alive. His RTK will engage. They're gonna bring back the Ember. He only initially finds the clicks. Now the BKB from Tyler. He's the man in front, focusing on the Tombstone. Envy getting chunked down. The grip from the high ground. DDC is gonna find him. Weeha deletes one, but it's only to Tuskar. And meanwhile, they chase forward, slicing up the Raptor and jumping back for Weeha. Isolated, surrounded, dodging again the stun. Maybe style points all over the place. Just desecrates the poor Lina, does Bloodstone deny, but dead nonetheless. I've seen so many Lotus Orbs like versus snowballs that just end in disaster for the team that has the Lotus Orb. I feel like that's the one spell where the Lotus Orb is usually bad, to be honest, because you never really expect it, you're not prepared for it, and it often just, like you said, just takes the hero entirely out of the fight for too long. Definitely not the scenario Puppy envisioned when he bought it, that's for sure. And maybe now with those double Divine Rapiers slapping away at Rex. Misery has the BKB, the Blink available as well. Maybe tries to jump in here on Mr. Maybe, but it's too late. Damage was done. Disruptor TPing in, looking for a glimpse back. Sylar has the BKB. They'll have to find DDC if they want to get a kill here. Or they'll have to Blink Crush to start. He will skate back. They get Vision still into the pit. Maybe retreating. 4.2k gold. Whole team fight now reassembled. Secret. Danger here now. Barracks are under attack. I definitely don't think you want to give Tuskaway like second stage. If they have the room to fit it in. It was Ember. I know it was Ember overall first. And then I thought it was Ember Darkseer. It was Ember Darkseer. Oh, the shards, not quite fully catching Misery, but they get the vision they need. Uppercut as the snowball comes in. They try to stun him, but the timing's not quite right. We had just a little bit off there. The possibly brought down MMY instead. He just struts away. Now with the starter BKB on cooldown, Lumi, can they fight? Can they contest? And they also blew the tombstone. We didn't mention that. Warrior now on the way for the Radiant side. It's a completed MKB coming out for Captain Sylar. Maybe about to get his next big item. Misery will glimmer, charges in. He could get the 5 hero crush. Oh, in a moment, but it would have been too far away from his team. Tombstone also going to be back, I believe. They have everything back, but Sylar's also a big item richer, and so too is Eternal Envy. Ibex, check him out. Maybe the only major hero to have one right now. He gets bashed in the pit. Oh, the timing on that one. Misery leaping in immediately. The BKB comes out from Sylar, and what do you know? A fresh and shiny double damage. Get the hell away from my rotate. Leave my team alone. And then the sleight of fist, the massive combo coming through. Sylar starts back in. He gets Laguna tapped down by Weeha. He didn't get to do the full complement of damage, but maybe keeps on chasing. He's going to isolate Puppy, hurting back and slicing up the Raptor. He wants some carved venison for dinner now. Or not. They're all rejoining the fight, but this is a big commitment. Push is low. Vacuum wall is down. They're going to have Ashimas again. Blinking in, jumping out. Snowball's there. Kiting and controlling. The back comes through. Big plays. Triple Remnant forward. Trying to engage into this one. And then maybe gets the chains off. He can dodge that stun. Yes, sirree. Maybe just making it look like child's play. He slices them again and again, running circles around Secret. And this is why LGD first picks maybe Ember Spirit. My god, he is a monster. Oh yeah, I love it. They let him get off the second vacuum with the Shivas. That definitely cost them any chance of a comeback.
Well, I guess
when he gets a rapier, it's such like a tactical rapier. You know, he's got the Aegis. They've just killed a bunch of enemy heroes. This is the number one pushing item he could grab just to take objectives and try to close out the game before heroes respawn. And he knows that the Lina's died back, so she can't buy back. He probably suspects that with the MKB on Eternal MV, he can. LGD, putting up the mid lane of Rax, looking for the GG. And with this win, Lumi.
One win left.
Yeah. They have to 2-0 here, or else Secret will still finish second, so the work's not done yet. But LGD heating up at the right moment. Misery engages. There's the Static Storm. BKB from Sylar as he just tries to fight his way through it. Misery can't do enough damage. MMY surrounded in the middle of the fight. Maybe sits back. He waits for his open. He even drops the defensive remnant. Safety first from the massive carry as he jumps forward. Off with your heads, and you as well, Puppy. Go home. Oh, Secret will drop game one.
had a